morning. We are live from the International Financiers Trading Room. What you're looking at right now is me shorting silver. It's been one of the hot commodities as of late. I've spoken about this in the past. It's really just in a really big range, I feel like, right now. Regarding all of this, let me pull up a separate chart because a lot of hype. Oh, it's gonna go to 20, 30, 40. Silver's been $60 at one point, and has not correlated like it always has with the precious metals, of precious metals, that being gold. We all love gold, don't we? And this is a big downtick in volume here. That's, you know, I kind of late. I got a signal almost a half hour ago. I waited for consolidation to get back to the Bollinger Band, the middle of it. Have my stop just outside the top side of it. And down it goes, pressing against the bottom of the band itself. So let me go over a quick little tidbit of silver. I'm kind of waiting on, I would love to add precious metals to my portfolio, but it's just hasn't, you know, I haven't seen any value in it. You know, and plus, equity markets are going up right now. Yes, so has silver, but it's just going back into this range that it was literally. I mean, Jesus, this is only back in, this is back in September, August, almost a year ago. You know, I mean, I can go back, you know, 20 years. Let's see what the high of 20 years. Probably the all-time high is $50. Look at that. $50 was the high. This was, you know, surprisingly right after 08, 2011. That's been the, always been the all-time high for silver and gold, for that matter. Had a nice bottom here at $12. Wow. And of course, you can go back to, you know, 10 years ago, or I'm sorry, 2002 was $4. So it's nothing. Oh, you know, it's gonna go up $2. You know, I mean, whoop-de-doo. It's not, you know, at the end of the day, yes, it's a commodity. It is a safe haven commodity, but it's just doesn't move along with the precious metals of precious metals. That being gold, that is going up, and that's going back up to, you know, look, it's all-time high, 1900. So it's not even close to the all-time highs. Do you really want to buy at the highs? This would have been a great time to buy down here and to push towards 1,000. I would like to see gold back into the 1300, 1400, even 1500. I might add to it. Just like, as you can see here, little range popped up, met the lows of the top of this range, popped up again. This is 08, 09. Look at that. Gold precious metal went down with the equity markets at the same time. People just went straight cash. Went up, range, went up, range, never really tested a little bit back of that range, and then the all-time highs. That's kind of what we're seeing right now, except the lows were nowhere near. Was, I mean, look at $255 for an ounce of gold back in 01. So, you know, pretty interesting stuff on the precious metals market works. I think I'm back into, back into a loss right now, into the negative in the silver. So we'll see how this trade goes. This video is kind of taking some time now, but as you can see, my faith in short shorting silver today is going to be good. I think we're going to have another up day in the market, as was yesterday. There was a lot of volume at the close, this should be said. This shows, you know, I did a little post about a 200 day, and obviously we've been above 3,000. Look at this major uptick at the close yesterday. This is massive. Look at that volume. Look at that volume. That volume. Where's the opening at? Tuesday. Okay. That volume was bigger than the opening. This is the opening right here. Opening is usually the highest volume, without a doubt. Look at the closing. Look at that confidence right now. For those who say we're not going into a V-shaped recovery, if you think for 1 second that the equity markets, and obviously everything else is going to be, equity markets are very forward-looking, all financial markets are very forward-looking. If you don't think we're in a V-shaped recovery, I think you need to go back to school and learn what the letter V looks like. It's obviously not going to be a direct correlation, but, you know, a lot of people say, oh, it's going to be like a sideways looking L or whatever the case may be. This is something even more impressive. Look at that. Look at that. That's not a V-shaped recovery. I don't know what is. Right now we are, what is this, 97? We're a little under 100 handles, 100 points under the all-time high for NASDAQ. You heard that right, folks. June 3rd, 2020. I think we're in stage level 3 of Jumanji. We're less than 100 points high, the all-time high on the NASDAQ. So, anyways, guys, I hope you enjoyed my video. I hope you enjoyed my spiel. I'm going to try and be your friend. Good luck hunting in the markets. Bye.